Hello everybody, and welcome to the Unreal Engine 4.14 how to render out of Unreal, basically. I'm going to be going over a few things: how to render video and how to render stills from Unreal Engine. This is meant to be just kind of like a quick start guide. It's not going into any of the details and like the super crazy things that you can get into with Sequencer. It's just for those really looking to get stills and maybe some quick pans and camera fly-throughs of their work. I'm making this basically because I haven't seen like anything online for it. Resources are really hard to come by, and it's just kind of a pain, so I decided I'd make something to help maybe start the resource creation for Sequencer and how to use these cameras and render out of Unreal. So I've gone ahead and created this scene already. Just labeled it camera scene. Nothing special. But first thing we're gonna do is I'm assuming you already have your scene made. This will work just fine for what we want to do, but I'm actually gonna lower the speed on this a little bit. But what we're gonna start off with is we're gonna go here. We're going to go to animation and add a level sequence. We can also go up to cinematics and add level sequence here. I'm gonna go ahead and use this and create a new folder. I think actually if you create a level sequence in the content folder right here, it will create a folder called cinematics for you. Nope, I guess not. Well, that's okay. It doesn't really matter where it is. But we're gonna take this here and move it into a nicer spot, just a little more centralized, easier to get to. And we're going to go ahead and double click on this. It's going to open Sequencer right here. I'm going to dock it up in the top window here. Am I not going to be able to dock it in this top window here? I guess not. I guess we'll just work with it like this. That's okay. So when you see this right here, the first thing you're going to notice is that it's relatively bare. It's not a very detailed user interface. However, once you get things in here, it can start being a little intimidating. So to start off, what we're going to do is we're going to go up to this icon here and create a new camera and set it as the current camera cut. And what this is going to do is it's going to do a lot of stuff for us and create this thing here and basically create this camera. This camera, actually, should be in our scene now. I'm on my other screen here, and what I'm doing is I'm just selecting this camera. Oh, there it is. A little hard to see. Okay. So, see the camera here, and you see in the bottom corner here we have our view. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to move this into a position that looks pretty good. Maybe back. So cool. We have the camera here, and we can actually go in. I'm going to bring this back over here. Now that we have our camera set up, I'm going to make this, I'm going to rename this to be render still. these two different cameras here. We're not going to worry about this one for right now. What we're going to do is we're going to render a still out with this camera here. And what we have to do actually is take and hit this plus button and select our render still. And it's going to give us our animation. What you have to do actually now is you can go in and narrow it down, and actually we'll render out a few frames just in case there's some buffer time, because the way the camera actually works is it takes a couple frames in the beginning and lets the scene actually render and bake and run in the background. So we're actually going to get a couple images out, and we can pick through them and choose the ones we want. So now that we have this camera cut set up with our render still, we're going to go up to here to this little clacker thing, and we're going to click it, and it's going to bring up render movie settings that we can go through and actually pick all the stuff apart and figure out what we want to make. The default location for renders out of Unreal is within the project folder, and for our purposes that'll be just fine. Most of the stuff is fine the way it is. You don't really have to change any of it really. So we're just gonna actually go ahead and hit capture movie. It'll ask you to save your scene before you do that, and in the top corner here you can see it rendering out, and that was it. That was done. So now we're gonna open our folder. And we have gotten a few things here. We have a few images here we can choose from. Doesn't really matter, we're just gonna delete one. And as you can see here, we have our render right out of Unreal. And it's cool. We got everything we needed, and it's nice. I'm gonna go ahead and close this, and we're gonna go ahead and make a movie this time. It's probably be cool if we animated a camera, right? It's probably gonna be good for our purposes. So here's our different, our other camera here that is our render video camera. And what we'll do is we'll just place this in some interesting way here. We'll have it go across here like that. That'll be kind of cool. So what we're going to do here, we have our starting position. And what we're going to do now is we're actually going to go into Sequencer and edit this transform key. We're actually going to add a new key, but first we need to make sure we are working with the correct indicator here. Okay, so, sweet. We have our little slider here, and we've set our first frame, and our first frame right here has stored the location of our first camera, of the camera's first position. So, let's make this a, three-second animation, 5 seconds. Let's make it 5 seconds. We'll just bring it back over here. So this red indicator actually will be the render area for the composition. So there, we're going to be rendering out 150 frames overall. Now what we want to do is if we render this out now, the camera's just going to stay in one position. We need to actually create a second position at the end where we want it to animate to. What we're going to do now is just take and move the camera over there. And we're going to actually open this back up. And in the transform tab, We're going to make sure our indicator is set to the end of frame 150. And we're going to hit the add new keyframe. Boom. So what we've done here is we've actually added an animation. I think this should work. So if we play this forward, we're not getting the camera updating like we wanted it to. There. Okay. Just had to redo it. Just had to remove the camera and draw the frame, and then add the key. Not sure why it wasn't doing it before, but now we have it, so... I'm not sure why it's creating this, like, second camera thing here. I'm just gonna take and delete it, and then move it back. So now we have this full movement. And if I drag the slider back and forth, I should be able to see the camera moving side to side. Cool. So now we're going to render this movie out. I like all these settings. We're going to do a video sequence just for the sake of time. And we're going to hit capture. We're going to save it again. It's going to go through each frame. Typically when it renders a little slower because it has to, it's using this cinematic camera that, actually adds a few post-processing effects, a little bit of depth of field, just to like, just to make it look really nice and like a cinematic right out of your game. Sweet. So let's go see what this looked like. Cool. And now what we can do is we can take these images or whatever, and we can use them in whatever video or whatever project you're using it for. It's really basic way. It doesn't really go into anything with like the camera crane or like the boom movements or anything, or actually messing with these even more. It's just to get some basic movements and basic renders out of